Hi students, welcome back to today's class. Now we are going to see another topic, that is reading from files. So how we can read the contents from the files, that we will see. Python provides mainly three types of read functions to read the data from the file. Okay, but before you can read from a file, the file must be open and it should be linked via the file object or file handle. Okay, so for that we need to use this statement: file one is equal to, that is file handle or file object name, equal to open, inside the parenthesis we need to enclose the path of the file from where we are reading, and if you are not mentioning access mode also, file access mode also, it will be defaultly read mode only. Okay, so the most common file reading functions of Python are listed here in this table. Okay, so first one is read function. Okay, read method. So the syntax for read method is file handle dot, that is file one dot read of n. So inside the parenthesis, that is the read function inside, read method inside, we need to pass how many number of bytes we need to read from that content, read from the data file. Okay, so here description is given. So it reads at most n bytes. So the read of n will read at most maximum of n bytes. If no n is specified, then it will read the entire file. If you are not mentioning this number n, so it will be reading the entire file. It returns the read bytes in the form of string. So what will be the output format? Output format will be in the form of string only. Okay, so example we will see here. So file one is equal to open, inside the parenthesis we have given the path. Okay, and then read information, that is the read information is equal to for our output variable we are assigning the statement called file one dot, that is file handle dot read. This syntax we applied here. So what is the file handle or file object here? So file one dot read of 15. Okay, read of 15 we have passed, so 15 bytes are going to be read from here, and then we are printing the output variable. Okay, so in that output variable, the whatever content we have read, that is going to be assigned to this read information. So print read information, that is going to be printed. So only 15 bytes are going to be read. So it is time to work with Python files or work with data files like that. One statement is going to be appear, but here only 15 we have mentioned. So up to WO, it is returning the answer. Okay. And type of read information, what will be the type of read information? What is the output variable's content? Content is belongs to which type? String data type. So bytes read information into string type. Next function is read line function. So before that we have seen read function, next is read line function, third one is read lines function. So the difference between the read line and read lines is that read line will read only one single line. So if you mention n here, reads a line of input. If n is specified, then reads at most n bytes only. It returns the read bytes in the form of a string. Okay, output will be in the form of string only, ending with line character. Okay, line character, or returns a blank string if no more bytes are left for reading in the file. Okay, it will be returning the left, it will be returning blank string if no more bytes are left for the reading in the file. Okay, so there are no files are there, no contents are there, it will be read as it will return as a blank string. Okay, so now we need to open the file before we use this read line syntax. Okay, read line function. So file handle dot read line of n only we need to give here. If you are not passing n, the first line is going to be read here. Okay, so file one is equal to open, we are mentioning the path of the file, and then file one dot read line. So this will read first line. Okay, so one line is read here. It will be assigned to read information, and then next we are printing read information. It's time to work with files. That statement up to the first line is going to be printed here. Next is read lines. So this read lines function, it will read all the lines and returns them as a list. So till now that read line function, read function, it is returning the answer in the form of string. But this read lines function method, it is returning the all the lines. It is reading all the lines from the file and returns them as a list in the form of list. Okay, so file one is equal to, first we need to open the file with the help of the file handle. Then with the help of file handle, we are going to use this function name read lines. Okay, so next we are printing that information. So here within a square bracket, that is list format, it is all the lines are read. Every line now is going to be printed as a element. Okay, so every line is printed here as element inside the list. Okay, what is the type of read information? List. Okay, list is printed. So read into list type. So how it is read? All the information, all the contents from that file is read into a list. Okay, so the file handle in the above syntax is the file object holding open files reference. So the file's reference is mentioned here in the file handle or file object. Now we will consider the following example code. Okay, example lines. Let us consider some examples now. For the examples and explanations below, we are using the file namely poem.txt. What is the file name called? This entire content is going to be saved in the file name called poem.txt. And this we are going to use it in the following examples. So first code snippet one is reading a line, reading a files, first 30 bytes and printing it. So from this previous poem now, we are going to read only the first 30 bytes. For that, we are going to use only read function. So before that, we need to create the file object. So file handle or file object is created with the help of my file is equal to open read mode. We are, that is a single space on single backslash only we are using now, so that we are using raw string. So W, that is R, small r indicates it's a raw string. Okay, poem.txt is a raw string. It is not indicating slash p or something else. Okay, so e colon slash poem.txt, inside e colon we have saved this text file. So that is we are opening in a read mode. And then even if you are not mentioning also, it will be open in read mode only. And then using output variable str, my file dot read of 30. So see the number of bytes to be read specified as argument of read. So inside the read, we have mentioned the argument value as 30. Okay, so 30 bytes alone will be read from this poem, poem.txt. And print str. Okay, when we specify the number of bytes with read, Python will read only the specified number of bytes from the file. The next read will start reading onwards from the last position where we read now. Again, if you are using read function from the same file, so from where we have left at the last read now, from that position onwards, it will start reading, okay, from the last position read. So code number two illustrate this fact. So this fact will be explained in the code snippet 2. Okay, so the output produced by the above code, by this code is only 30 bytes are returned. Up to try, it will be returning. Okay, so next we may combine the file function and open function with the file objects function. Okay, with the file objects function, like what? Read lines. Okay, with the file object function, if you need to perform you just a single task on the open file. Okay, so that is we may combine file or open function with the file object function. That is with the read function, we may combine this file function also, or we may combine this open function also. If you need to perform just a single task, here we have performed only single task like read. Okay, here read line. So if you just perform a single task on the open file, you can use this file object function and also what function? File function or open function. Okay, if you want to perform only single task, we can use this open function and file object function also. We can combine. Okay, then you may combine the two steps of opening the file and performing the task. Okay, the following statement, file. Okay, file function we are using file and raw string and single backslash only we have used here, and comma read mode dot read of 30 will give you the same output. Okay, first function, that is first function will open the file. This is used by the Python interpreter as a first function. If you have used two functions here, first this will be done first. Okay, so first function will open the file. This one only will be opening the file, and the second function will perform the result of first function, that is the reference of open file. So after opening the file, the read work is performed. Okay, would give the same result as that of above code. So this statement and this one will be giving you the same output. Okay, so these three lines and this line will be giving the same output for you. Next is, for example, the following code will return the first line of the file poem.txt, that is open same file function. Instead, we have used here open function, and instead of read function, we have used readline function. So here, with the help of open and file function, we have done only one task only. So if you want to perform just a single task on the opened file, you can combine this file object function. This is only file object function, and this one is file function or open function. So open poem.txt, r. Then you need to close this function dot, okay, dot after read line. So it will read only the first line of the file poem.txt. So next we will see code snippet 2, that is reading n bytes and then reading some more bytes from the last position read. So this only we are going to see here. The next read statement, if you are using continuously two read statements, no, the next read statements will start reading onward from the last position read. So for that we will see this example. So we are reading n bytes and then reading some more bytes from the last position read. Okay, so my file is equal to open, this is the file handle or file object, is equal to open, and or within single quotes we have mentioned the file path of the file, comma r, close the parenthesis, str is equal to, this is the output string. To this string we are assigning this, we are going to perform the read operation from the file name called poem.txt. So my file dot read of 30, so it will read 30 bytes. Next we are printing that str. Okay, so this like output will be obtained for the first one. Then in str2 we are assigning, we are going to read the next 50 bytes of data from the last position where we left. Okay, and my file dot read of 50, so print str of 2. After that we need to close the file, my file dot close. Okay, so this second one's output will be like this. Okay, so output by second print statement, print str2. So print has entered a new line after its output, so it will be printing from the next line onwards. Okay, so next, if you don't want to have do not want to have a new line characters inserted by print statement, see like this new line characters, if you don't want to have, you can use, okay, in the read function itself we can use the stripe function. Okay, so there is n equal to statement also, we can use it. If you don't want to have a new line characters inserted by print statement in the output, then you can use end is equal to in the print statement. Okay, so here comma within double quotes end equal to, we can use it. Okay, see here comma end within double quotes end equal to, we can use it. End equal to double opening close opening quotes and closing quotes, single quotes you need to use it. Okay, in the end of print statement, so that the print does not put any additional new line characters in the output. So we can see the code snippet 3 and 4 here. So just if you see this, it is going to read the entire file content. Okay, so my file is equal to open, the file name we have mentioned, file path, and comma r mode, that is read mode, and str is equal to my file dot read. So this will read, we have not mentioned any number of bytes here, no value is specified as reads argument, and entire file is going to be read now. So print of str my file dot close, so entire statement is going to be printed with the new line characters also. Okay, if you see this code snippet 4, just we have enclosed within the double quotes, not simply we can give after comma as a second argument. Okay, so print str comma end is equal to double quotes, if you give, no, see here first line is printed with the help of this read line. So the reading files first three lines line by line. Okay, line by line it is going to read all the lines. Okay, so that is three lines alone, because we have given only three read line statements here. So str is equal to my file dot read line, so that new line character is going to be removed. Okay, so argument end is equal to at the end of print statement will ensure the output shows exact content of the data file and no print inserted new line characters. No print statement will insert the new line character exactly how it is given in the input file, same like it will be printing. Okay, next str is equal to my file dot read line, it will be reprinting the third line. Okay, and my file dot close, the first line, this is second line, this is third line. So new line also, this blank line also is going to be read by the second one. Okay, and next reading a complete file line by line. Okay, so for reading line by line also, read line statement we have used here, and while looping statements and for looping statements also we can use it here in order to read the complete file line by line. So for that, before that we need to create the file handle or file object with the open function. Okay, so open inside we have mentioned the file path and comma read mode, and we are assigning initially to string, no, is empty. Okay, so empty value we are assigning to str initially, storing space, that is any none value is assigned to this str. Okay, and within double quotes, simply double quotes with space, we need to assign to str, and while str, that is until we reach the last line of the str, no, so up to that this task is going to be performed. Okay, so str is equal to, so until str is true, these two statements will be executed. Okay, so str is equal to myfile dot read line, and print str is equal to end is equal to, so similar like how we have seen in poem.txt lines, no, same kind of lines will be printed, and then afterwards file will get closed. Okay, so the output produced by the about code will print the entire content of the file poem.txt. See, this is the use of while statement. Okay, in the same manner for loop also we can use, that we will see it here with the help of this syntax and example. Okay, the same output only will be produced by the following this three lines. Okay, and the read line function reads the leading and trailing spaces, that is before and after the spaces and all is there, no, everything is going to be read, if any, along with the trailing new line character also while reading a line. So when it is reading the line, leading spaces, trailing spaces, and then new line character, everything is going to be read. Okay, so you can remove this leading and trailing white spaces or tabs or new lines using strip command. Okay, strip function. Okay, so that strip or the strip function is going to be used without any argument, as explained below. That is, in the next page we will see how this strip function will be working. So what will be the size of the file if we use strip function when it is removing the new lines, no, new spaces and tabs and new lines and all, no? So new line character and the tab character space spaces also is going to be considered as one character or one byte by the Python interpreter. So after removal, how many number of bytes are there in the entire poem.txt? Let us see with the help of this strip function. It is used to remove the leading and trailing white spaces, new lines, from the given file. Okay, so recall the strip without any arguments removes leading and trailing white spaces. So you need to remember that without any argument only we need to use this strip function in order to remove the leading and trailing white spaces. There is another way for printing a line by line, printing a file line by line. So how we have printed till now, with the help of this while str, no, in the same manner we can use for loop also in order to print the file line by line. So this is simpler way, where after opening the file you can browse through the file using its file handle line by line by writing the following code. That is, file handle is equal to open file name and any read mode you can give, and for variable in file handle. Okay, so the file handle we need to give here, print that variable. So here line, we are going to choose as the variable. Okay, for line and my file, so this statement is constant. So my file is equal to open or the path of the file comma read mode we have given, for variable name line in my file, that is in the file handle or file object, print line. So this statement also will give you the output in a similar manner like how we have used this while str. Okay, in the same manner we will get the output. The output produced by the above code is just the same as the output produced by the above program. The reason behind this output is that when you iterate over a file handle using a for loop, this is using file handling over, when you are iterating, that is when you are repeating it using a for loop, then the for loops variable moves through the file line by line. That variable line is there, no, that will be going through the file line by line, where a line of file is considered as a sequence of character. So here the line of file is going to be considered as a sequence of character. Okay, so without using read line we have used for loop in order to read the entire line. So but here in this while str, no, we have used read line function, but here we didn't use read line. It will be considering that the loop variable moves through the file line by line, where a line of file is considered as a sequence of characters up to and including a special character called the new line character. Up to that new special character, that is new line character, it will be moving on. So the for loops variable starts with the first line, and with each iteration it moves to the next line. So for loop variable, how it will be moving? That line variable is there, no? That line. Okay, this is the for loop variable. This will be moving, starts with the first line, and then with each iteration, that is every step, every iteration after, every line after, it moves to the next line. As the for loop iterates to through the each line of the file, the loop variable will contain the current line of the file as a string of characters. Okay, and now code snippet 6, displaying the size of the file after removing UAL character with the help of what? How we can remove this end of line characters, leading and trailing white spaces and all, blank lines and all, with the help of the strip command. So that also we will see here. Without strip, how it is printing, and with strip, how this program is going to print the number of bytes from the file, we will see here. So my file is equal to open. We are opening the file with the help of R mode, that is read mode. STR1, we are emptying that space. Okay, initially storing a space, any non-none value is stored here for STR1. First we are assigning size as 0 and total size as 0. So size is used to indicate, used to print the size of the file after removing this UAL characters, leading and trailing white spaces, everything. This T size is going to return what? T size is going to return the total size without removal. Okay, so this is with using strip function, this will be displaying the answer. Without using strip function, this T size will be returning the answer to you. So while str1 is used as a variable, okay, string variable to hold the final output, my file dot read line, so line by line it is going to be read. And then T size is equal to T size, that is total size is 0 initially, len of str1. So the entire line with the leading and trailing white spaces, everything is going to be included in this length function. Okay, that is going to be added to T size. Okay, next, size is equal to size plus len of str1 dot. Okay, in this str1 itself, we are going to remove the leading and trailing white spaces with the help of the strip function. So this strip function, where it is used, just noted here. When you want to find out the length of the string inside that that variable after dot, okay, so that's str1 only will be having that line, read line, whatever lines we have read, that line will be stored in this str1 variable only. And this str1 is now from this str1 we are going to remove the leading and trailing white spaces and blank lines with the help of the strip function, and close this length function, and then finally the size is calculated. So after removal of the leading and trailing white spaces, the size variable will be holding the actual size without, size without the EOL and white spaces, no, it will be printing here. Okay, that is 360 number of bytes only is returned. Size of the file after removing all EOL characters and blank lines, 360 only number of bytes for the total poem.txt. And if you print this T size, that is total size, the total size of the file will be T size. Okay, that is 387. If you see here, around 27 white spaces, blank lines, leading trailing white spaces and all included as a character here in this poem.txt. Okay, so after performing all these functions, you need to close the file with the help of myfile.close. Okay, you can see here, whatever statements we are executing inside the while, that is, this is going to be considered as a block of statements inside this while string. And this first four lines and the last three lines is considered to be, first five lines and last three lines are considered to be main statement, main block. Okay, and all the above code fragments read the contents from the file in a string. Okay, so in this string, every code fragment is going to read the contents from the file. And however, if you use read lines, okay, however, if you use read lines, notice yes is end of the function. Okay, then the contents are read in a list. Go through the next code fragment. Okay, if you use read line instead, read lines. Okay, so what will happen? Everything is going to read as, look at the output here. Okay, read lines has read the entire file in a list of strings. So in a list of strings, in a, like a list of strings, it is returning the answer, where each line is stored as one string, where each line is stored as one string here. So now that you are familiar with these reading functions working, let us write some programs related to this read and read line, everything, okay? So write a program to display the size of the file in bytes, size of the file we need to display. Okay, so just we can give ln of str, which is assigned to size after reading. See here, my file is equal to open with the help of raw in raw string. Okay, we are giving a raw string here, and within single quotes e colon, the entire path is given, comma, read mode we are opening, and str is the output variable where we can read the content and we can store the content. So str is equal to my file dot read. So my file is referring to this poem.txt. From this the lines are read. Okay, so here we didn't mention any number of bytes, so entire file is going to be read. So entire file size is calculated with the help of this length function, and that is assigned to this size. And finally, we are printing the size. The size of the given file poem.txt is. Next statement, we are printing size bytes. That is, the size is going to be printed as like this. It is printed 387 bytes. Okay. Now write a program to display the number of lines in the file. See read lines, read line, and see read line. We should not use read lines here. Read line. And then line count is equal to len of s. So we are printing that line count here. After that, we are closing the file. Here also, you need to close the file. Okay, my file dot close. Okay, so number of lines in poem.txt is 18. 18 lines are there in the poem.txt, including that white spaces also. Then writing onto files. After working with file reading functions, okay, let us talk about the writing functions for data files available in the Python. So if you use writing functions, it'll be overwriting the existing file if already some contents are there in the file, means like reading function, the writing function also work on the opening files. That is the files that are opened and linked via the file object or file handle. First, we need to open the file in write mode. Okay, so write and write lines. Write line function is not there. Only two functions we have here in the writing functions. Okay, as the writing functions. Write function syntax is file handle dot write of str1. Okay, which string you are going to write, that is going to be included inside this write statement. So write a string str1 to a file referenced by file handle, and then file handle dot write lines of l. So write all strings in list l. So like a list, no, we are going to pass here inside the write lines, and it is going to be returned to the file referenced by this file handle. So file handle in the above syntaxes is the file object holding the open files reference. Which file is open, that file's reference or link is going to be assigned to this file object, or it is pointing to that link, okay, pointing to that file. And next is appending a file. So this appending a file we will see in the next video. So until then, you just revise the previous videos and be ready for your test.